In this Photoshop tutorial, I will explain how to swap two faces between each other and how to make them look realistic in their new bodies. The photo we will use can be a photo of two people side by side, or two completely different photos. Let's open these two photos that we want to do face transplantation and swap their faces with each other, and let's start our work right away. First of all, let's open the photos that we want to change the faces between themselves with Photoshop. Our goal here will be this. We are going to cut the face of this man here and replace it with this man's face. At the end of the tutorial, we will make it look as if this man's face is really here, really belonging to this man, this body. That's the realism of it. Let's go to our other image first and take the lasso tool here. Let's select the lasso tool. Let's get a little bit closer to the man's face and select around the man's face. We will not take the beard below. I select the face like this with the lasso tool and press Ctrl+C. Ctrl+C will copy the selection and then I move to the next image. I go to the image where I want to put the face and with Ctrl+V I paste this image. The image I just selected here. The lasso tool is still selected here. I select the move tool and let's lower the opacity of this one a little bit. In the layer panel here, let's lower the opacity to 60%. We also need to see the original photo so that we can match it exactly. I'm zooming a little bit more and press Ctrl+T. Ctrl+T is the shortcut for transform. Let's match these eyes first like this. We are going to have to enlarge the face a little bit more. So, I enlarge the face like this. I rotate it slightly and try to match the eyes, nose, mouth with the background as much as I can. And that's it. By pressing Enter, I can turn off the transform feature and make the opacity value 100%. As you can see, it is not very realistic right now. We are already at the beginning of our steps. Our next step is to try to simulate the colors here. To try to simulate the colors with the original image in the background. In order to do this, let's first select the face that we put here. And Ctrl click. And you will see that there are dashed lines around the edges. Around the edges of the face. Indicating that there is a selection. The next step is to select the match color option under adjustments. By selecting match color, a window like this will open. What we need to do in this window is to determine the path of the original image in the background. We have two options. One of them is this, our original image. The other one is the image from which we cut the face. We will find this image. This image, I'm selecting this and then the layer options will open. When we look here, in the layer options, we see that the background is the original image. The face we just added is the one on top. We will select the background here. As you can see, as soon as I select background, this face image we edit will try to adapt to the color of the environment. You can also change the scroll bars here, if you think it will look better. But I want to leave it at default and click OK. The face we edit here is still selected. I press Ctrl+D. It means deselect. And I'm going to create a copy of the background. I create a copy of the currently selected layer using the key combination Ctrl+J. I press Ctrl+J. A copy is created. I change the name of this one, so I know what it is. I call it original and I turn off the visibility of the image called background. Now, it's time to merge the frame of the face with the background. We will use the blend feature here. In order to do this, I control click once on the icon on the left of the layer as we just did. This area is selected and then I hover over the layer I just created. This area is selected and then I hover over the layer I just created. Duplicate it and under select, under modify, I select contract. Here is the logic of contract. It will shrink the selected pixels, that is, the pixels that we see as moving here, inward. Since the value of this will actually change according to the image, you need to give it in these settings. For example, when I want 5 pixels to go in, there will be an entry of this amount. I mean like this. This will be enough for the work we will do. You can also make a bleed-in with more or less these settings in this pixel value. Now, when we do this, again with the original selected, which we have just selected, I press the delete key. The delete key will delete the original face on this back. I press it and as you can see, it is erased it here. And if I make it invisible, I will see an image like this. Let's make it visible again. What we are going to do now is to blend the outer layer, the outer frame of the face here with the original image in the background. And this is how we are going to do it. There are selected areas here. Let's first deselect them. I press Ctrl+D and select both layers here. Then you will see the Auto Blend layer option under Edit. Let's click on that. In this Auto Blend layers window that opens, Let's select the Stack Images option and click OK. After clicking OK, in a short time, the face image we added here will merge with the original image in the background and create a realistic image. This technique is a very impressive technique. This was actually the original photo and he switched to this. So what did we do? We took the image here and replaced it with the face of the man here. With this method, we changed the face of the photograph in this way. There is no trace on the edges or anywhere that this face was added to this photo later. This increases the realism and quality of the work. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.